special segment about someone's holiday magic. Kim, Kate, do you have any special holiday traditions?
Yes, I do. Me and my family like to snuggle up and eat fluffernutter.
All right. Now let us get to Sherry. Sherry will be making us her traditional holiday meal.
Hi. I can't believe I'm on the TV. Is it okay if I say hi to my friends from book club? Hi, Carol. Hi, Dorf. Hi, Marge.
Hi there. What will you be making for us today?
I'll be making my family's favorite Christmas traditional recipe, Frosty the Slaw Man. It's been a tradition in my family since 1920. My mom made it, my mom's mom made it, my mom's mom made it.
Wow, that certainly is a long time. Let's get started.
Okay, first you're going to add your cup of cold water. Then you're going to add your 6 cups of gelatin. Next, you're going to add 3 spoonfuls of meal. You really want to feel this in your heart.
That'd
be great, guys.
Can you perhaps substitute Miracle Whip?
A Miracle Whip? Oh no, absolutely not. Miracle Whip is just a salad dressing and will not, absolutely not, be used in my recipe.
No.
Then you're gonna add your 3 pounds of cottage cheese. Oh, this is non-fat cottage cheese. You wanna pay good attention because we can only use full-fat cottage cheese. Let me get my daughter on the horn. Hey, Jessica, I got you on the speakerphone. Can you hear me okay?
Yeah, I can hear you just fine. What do you want?
Well, I'm in the studio and I need some cottage cheese. Can you go to the Piggly Wiggly and get me some?
Yeah, I can do that for you. I'm at the pig right now grabbing rats.
Okay, thanks, hon. Next. Oh, wait, I almost forgot. I brought some of my famous Scotcheroos to hand out to everyone. Thank you.
When you're making this salad, do you often, does it stay thick or does it thin down quite a bit over the course of mixing it?
It will not thin down. And in fact, it's time for us to add our coleslaw. It's going to be wonderful. Okay, so you can add your finely chopped or grated coleslaw.
Now, which is better, the grated or finely chopped?
I prefer to finely chop because it really helps add a structure to Frosty. Now, I want you to pay good attention now, okay? So, you see how I can't mix this? It's too heavy. It's too hard. So you really need to get your hands in there and just really mix it up, boy. Come on. What do you need to do? Come on. This is more new experience. This is your family tradition.
It's a Christmas miracle.
and welcome to the TTTTT, Take Two Thespian Theater Troupe, that is. We are the only theater company in the world to produce a play written entirely by ChatGPT, Business Christmas, and Fruitcake Kisses. I'm so happy that you all are here for our first reading of our script for this play. All right, everyone, let's get started. Business Christmas and Fruitcake Kisses. Emily's business office. Night. Emily, sharp, sophisticated lawyer. Sit at desk. Type furiously on laptop.
There's so much business!
Yes, it is unfortunate that there was always business in your holiday.
Emily phone buzzes. Call from hometown.
Hometown calling? What could possibly be so urgent in hometown?
She answers the call. And her expression changes as she listens.
I must go back to hometown. Hometown? What is there? Boring and romance? I don't know. Business say I have to go.
Exterior, hometown square in the daytime. Emily steps out of taxi, greeted by the nostalgic charm of the small town, beautifully decorated for Christmas. She takes in the sights and the sounds, a mix of excitement and uncertainty on her face.
Hey, you!
It's a long time, friend.
No time. Business.
Emily, hat, briefcase. Interior, we find ourselves in the fruitcake plant office in the morning. Emily enters the fruitcake plant's office to find Jake, her high school sweetheart. Now, the plant manager. Eyes meet. And there's a moment of silent recognition.
You are the manager?
Laughing.
Ha!
Surprise.
They exchange awkward pleasantries, both feeling the weight of the past.
I never thought I'd be back here.
Life has a funny way of bringing you full circle.
Business says, Fruitcake plant must close.
Hand papers.
Sign.
Now we find ourselves in the town square, midday. Emily and Jake argue passionately about the plant's fate. Their heated exchange echoing through the festive square.
It's just business!
It's town legacy!
Their argument draws the attention of the townsfolk. Watch drama unfold.
They were high school sweethearts, you know?
Others nod, noddingly. We find ourselves now at a school concert in the nighttime. Amid the holiday decorations, Emily and Jake find themselves attending a Christmas concert. The choir sings a soul-stirring carol. As they glance at each other, there's a moment of shared nostalgia.
I take you for a ride on Nutcracker. We go slower, we go faster. Down through woods and out to pasture. Long as I'm with you, it do not matter.
Never change.
Now we find ourselves in the town park the next morning. Snow falls gently. As Emily and Jake share a quiet moment, the tension softens, replaced by a sense of shared history and understanding.
Maybe they're more to life than business.
Jake looks at her, smile face.
You always did have a way of seeing the enormous painting of lifetime.
Now we find ourselves at Emily's penthouse in the nighttime. Back in the city, Emily decides to save the planet with 2.5 million. But there's a condition.
I save the planet, Jake, but we need merit!
She paces, nervously, waiting for her response.
Musing. Marriage. That's quite the Christmas miracle. And so, in heart of Christmas, not tradition save mortal plant, they save each other with marriage.
Thank you.
has always been pathetic. I suppose the guy who stole my credit cards, the guy who tried on my clothes, and so a row of self-help books lie on my bedroom shelves. There's one rule those books forget: we never fall in love. Christmas town will test your every nerve.
because, yeah, frosting the slaw man is real. And just do a quick internet search and you can make it a part of your holiday traditions too. Speaking of delicious food, we have one more performance before a 15-minute intermission. There will be cookies, candies, chips, water, and more available for purchase at our concession stand in the lobby, including Swiss Colony Butter Toffees. Thank you, Colony Brands, for donating these tasty treats. And now, here are the MHS Combined Choirs with Children Go Where I Send Them.
Thank you. Cause I got my love to keep me warm. while our choir members are heading to their spots quietly, while they're heading to their spots quietly for our last couple numbers here, I just wanted to give a few thank yous. First, we'll give a thank you to Mrs. Baum, middle school choral director. Give a round of applause, please. We want to give a round of applause to our high school band director, Ms. Hinkey. Queen of the Pack, who is one of the reasons that all of this has come together. She makes everything happen, Ms. Bochar. Our theater crew advisor, Ms. Davis, for helping everything work smoothly backstage. Round of applause, Ms. Davis, please. We'd like to thank all of our musicians, Mary Soddy, Maggie Sederstrom, Sarah Bodell, Patrick Bodell, and Tracy Powelson. We'd like to thank our AV Center for all the posters and programs that you see. That's Heidi Witt and Karen Pax as well. Round of applause. A special thanks to Colin Brands, Mainstream Monroe, Don Mulligan, Nicole Saunders, Kate Carpenter, Olivia Lentz, Chandra and Rich Depri, and Erica Zettner, please, for all of their work for the run backstage. Coming and supporting the arts. We have two more numbers for you, as well as a skit in between, but it's really important that we say this has been an awesome experience for us putting this together. The kids have worked really, really hard on this, and you guys are a big testament to that. You bring them to all these extra rehearsals, you support them in everything you do. So students, can we give a round of applause for all of our audience members here, please? Finally, we'd like to thank the students. Students, you work hard. You give us a reason to do what we do every day. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
ball drop thing, maybe?
We should do something that isn't a ball drop, though. Something more Monroe.
Great idea. Any suggestions?
How about something green? I mean, we are Green County after all.
Ooh, we could drop grass.
Where are we gonna find grass this time of year?
Okay, well, how about we drop something we can't find?
Ooh, like a pine tree!
And how exactly would we drop an entire pine tree?
Let me show you. Okay.
So, imagine this. We have a crane. We rent a crane and we have it hold the pine tree. This is the clock tower, bing bong, bing bong. And we drop it in front of the clock tower. Then we have balloons. Balloons.
We'll workshop that idea. What about a mouse?
Ooh, yeah, everybody likes mice. I mean, look at Mickey, Stuart Little, Chunk and Cheese.
A mouse would be way too small. After my appearance on Brady Green County, I think we should drop my famous scotcheroos.
Oh, someone thinks she's an influencer now.
How about a cow?
How would that work exactly?
Like in that movie, Jurassic Park, like, you know, like...
That's a cow.
Oh, 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 I got it! A cheese curd. But what kind of a cheese curd?
Fresh!
Fried cheese curds are a staple of the Wisconsin family diet. It's what makes us Wisconsinites. Come on now.
Fresh is the only way to do it. Why should we ruin our good cheese with that fried, greasy goop?
But everyone eats the cheese curd!
I mean, this is weird.
That we can all agree on. A cheese that really embodies Monroe.
Which is midnight in Switzerland.
Thank you. applause to all our former since Donald are on stage right now. Please give a wave for your sixth grade choir and wave for your sixth grade choir.